with a statue. So now I'm a walking living legend.
The bronze bomber Deontay Wilder thinks his name will be ranked with boxing legends like Muhammed Ali, Sonny Liston, and Rocky Marciano.
To sleep.
So does the American one-hitter deserve to be in the Hall of Fame for what he's done?
It's good to talk. It's good to show emotion. It's good to have, you know, show expression about it.
Well, let's take a look at the video. But before we jump in, remember, like, subscribe, and tap the icon bell so you don't miss out on any updates.
There's a great shot at Eagle.
And that staggered Brazil. And Wilder went after him. Wilder went after him, and then Brazil pretty much turned around.
Deontay Wilder is confident his name ends up alongside the likes of Muhammad Ali, Sonny Liston, and Rocky Marciano in the International Boxing Hall of Fame. What makes him say that? The bronze bomber's known for an unwavering belief in himself, and why not? His knockout power has been hailed by some fans and fighters as the most devastating in the history of the sport.
Yeah. All the division games, all the heavyweights are watching
me. And you know, you get the sense that
he won the WBC heavyweight title in 2015, bringing the belt back to America for the first time since 2007 after what was the longest period in history without a U.S. champion in the division. It was his to defend until 2020, and he did so 10 times.
He started, and terrific power. Even when he squared up, he was able to knock him down.
Despite perhaps not facing as many other top contenders as fans would like, the Alabama fighter has 45 fights, 42 wins, 41 knockouts. Understandably, with numbers like that, modesty does not come easy. Wilder told Boxing Scene he's a Hall of Famer now, and he's certain he'll be formally inducted in the future. One of his three showdowns against Fury, Wilder carefully ushered all of his opponents to the canvas and into the medical tent.
If we never forget, when I found you were strung out on coke. When I found you was like a big house, contemplating about killing yourself.
If we talk about Wilder's most brutal skills, we can name heavyweights like Arturo Spilka, Bermain Stiverne, and Dominic Brazil, and Luis Ortiz. Let's look at Arturo Spilka, January 2016. Wilder was making his third defense of the WBC title when he made an example of Polish southpaw Spilka. In round 9, a massive right hook sends him to the heap on a floor, unconscious, legs folded. Spilka was immediately treated by ringside medical personnel, and Wilder later revealed he feared he had killed his opponent. Then it's Bermain Stiverne, November of 17. Wilder had won the title from Stiverne in 15, the only time he had gone the distance until that point. And after Luis Ortiz had withdrawn from the initial fight, Wilder was given a chance to rectify that when Stiverne filled in on late notice. The Canadian was floored three times within 3 minutes, and the fight stopped. Final knockdown saw Stiverne splattered on the ropes after a four-punch combination, down on his knees, out for the count.
Wilder with another big shot at the end. Wrong. Boom. Leaping shot. Stiverne had not fought in quite.
Luis Ortiz, March of 2018. This was their first match. The Cuban Luis Ortiz hands Wilder his first real test and scare after picking himself up from the canvas, and he hurts the bronze bomber.
Wilder's conditioning coming to play as we get towards the middle rounds.
Wilder escaped defeat by the skin of his teeth at the end of round 7 and recovered to get the job done. Ortiz was dropped twice in the 10th with a brutal uppercut closing the show. Then it's Dominic Brazil, May 2019. Wilder was in talks to fight Brazil for years before it finally came to fruition, and it ended before it even began.
That would be wise. There's a big... Brazil is in! And we're in the trouble! Wilder's going after him!
A massive right hand in the first round rocks Brazil's head and leaves him flat on his back. Wilder warned Fury the hatred he feels toward him is the same he felt towards Brazil. And we know how that is.
The finish. Bang! Good night. Well, boom!
Wilder was last in the ring October 2021 and recently announced his return with the key ambition to challenge and reign once more. There was a period of time when he was considering hanging up the gloves. However, he decided against it, and he'll be back in the ring October 15th to face an in-form Robert Helenius. This is the match that marks the return of Wilder after the legendary trio with Tyson Fury was his only chance to get back to the top before he became a recession. And it also was a way for him to prove he can be honored to be on the same level as the legends of heavyweight boxing.
But Jim Washington wants the pace and the timing. Oh, big right hand, and down goes...
After a long, contentious trilogy against Fury, Wilder took a deep breath. Though he no longer had his WBC heavyweight title, the Alabama native's bank account was plush with generational wealth. Considering his financial success both in and out of the ring, Wilder thought long and hard before ultimately deciding to continue his career.
And this one, and look at Wilder, he's pouring it off the left hook, and this one is over. Deontay Wilder.
And now the 36-year-old moves forward. He'll look forward to regain that winning feeling October 15th when he squares off against Helenius at Brooklyn's Barclays Center.
He's in trouble early in the round. A lot of time left in this round.
He has a very
In an effort to get back on track, Wilder has immersed himself in an arduous training camp while enduring countless rounds of sparring. For Wilder, the hope is to eventually place Helenius on the seat of his pants. However, should the hard-hitting former titleist come up short, he doesn't believe that a defeat will sully his name. Having defended his WBC title a total of 10 times, tied with Muhammad Ali for the fifth most in heavyweight history, coupled with the reputation as being a devastated knockout puncher, Wilder is of the belief he has solidified his standing as an all-time great.
Champion Wilder with a left hook. Oh, and the left hook drops down.
So
he's
clearly
down once, you know, prior.
And I think the temple shot.
Wilder, though, has brazenly stated his ultimate goal, a second title reign. But even if the loquacious former champion is unsuccessful this time around, keeping him out of the Hall of Fame, it's virtually impossible in his mind. So do you think former champion Deontay Wilder deserves to be on the list for the Hall of Fame? Leave your comments below and let us know. And don't forget, like, subscribe, tap the bell icon. You don't want to miss any videos from Boxing Insane. Stay safe, and we'll see you next time.
Well, there's a great shot, and he-